So I showed you how to do three sampling techniques: netting, pan trapping, and observational sampling. Now I have some bee specimens here that I obtained through netting and pan trapping. Remember, for observational sampling, you will not be collecting any specimens. So I'm going to show you how to prepare your specimens for curation or mounting. So here are the bees that I have in my kill jar that I got through netting. These are the easiest to prepare for curation. I take off the lid. Now I had a paper towel in there because it helps give the bees something to hold on to. And in here I have three bees and leaves. Now what you want to do with these bees is put them in a storage vial. If you're going to mount them immediately, you don't need to do this. But when you collect bees, they can stay in your freezer for about a week. If you leave them longer than a week, you will have to relax them, which is a whole different process. So here I have a storage vial. You can also get cheaper and smaller storage vials, but these are the ones I like. Now, if you recall in our previous video, I told you that you have to make a label when you collect your bees. So on my label, I have written the date, the location, I wrote which transect I was on, and the name of the plants, Rousia ambigua. So I'm going to keep all of the bees that I got from that area together. Actually, you can just pick the specimens up with your fingers. They are very pliable at this point. If you freeze them for a week, they may be a little more brittle, so be careful. Now we will go over how to prep bees that you've collected in ethanol. Remember, this is your whirl pack, so I'm going to go over to the sink. This is what we like to call our bee salon. So you're going to open the whirl pack. Remember, ethanol is not going to hurt you. You can do this with gloves if you like, but I tend to not use gloves for it. You're going to pour the ethanol into your strainer. Now you have to rinse your bee. Remember that they are pretty pliable at this point, so you just run a stream of water over your bee. Now, even if you're looking at pollen on your bee, it will not come off while rinsing. So now that you have rinsed your bee, you are going to do the first part of drying and fluffing your bee. Remember, you want the hair on the bee to show. So we're going to put it on the paper towel, and I have three paper towels here. You will put two paper towels on top, and then I pat the bee, and you can see water is coming off the bee. So the reason that you need to dry and fluff your bee is because we use the hair on the bee, and we call these pollen collecting hairs, or scopae, to identify the bees, among other characteristics. But you need your bee nice and fluffy in order to identify it. So I would leave my bee sitting here for at least 15 minutes until you start the blow drying process. Now this is the fun part. Here I have a mason jar, obviously. Now I have taken a very thin sock and put it over the opening of the mason jar. You can also use nylons if you can still find them. I know these aren't really in fashion anymore. Now what you're going to do is put your bee or bees in the mason jar. You want to keep all your bees from your transect together, but don't mix them from multiple transects. I'm going to put the lid on. Now, you want a blow dryer that you can set to cool. You do not want to blow dry these bees on warm or hot. You will make them too brittle for mounting. So I have the bee in the mason jar. I'm going to turn it upside down. My blow dryer is on cool. I usually put it on high power and I blow dry like this. I turn it upside down so that I can blow the bees off of this surface. They have a tendency to stick to it. You want the bees to tumble around in the mason jar and become nice and fluffy. So you can look at your bees after you blow dry, and I usually blow dry for maybe 30 seconds at first, especially if you have small bees. Your small bees will get brittle very quickly. In fact, you can even remove your small bees after like 30 seconds and continue to blow dry your larger bees. So now I take my bee out, I look, and I see that the scopae are fluffy. So now you are done preparing your specimen. So now that our bee has been processed, we are ready to go to the microscope for curation, which means mounting the bee.